following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do a great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We got 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Love coming out of you makes you happy. The whole world can love you, but that's not the love that'll make you happy. What will make you happy is to share the love you have inside of you. That is the love that will make the difference. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 171. NASDAQ is down 15. S&Ps are up 1.5. Gold contract up $5.50, trading at $12.08 an ounce. Silver up 9 cents, $14.28 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.27, $71.12 a barrel. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year note, down 6 ticks, 118.19. 30-year bond off 11, 141.02. King dollar. King dollar down 106 ticks, 94.120. The euro is at 116.75 to one US dollar. The yen is at 112.25 to one US dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. One note's going on in your world. In the world of the bonds and notes, let's go take a look at them first. What I want to do out here, folks, we want to go first off into the 10-year note. Why the 10-year note? Well, the 10-year note, folks, broke its August lows. We're going to go after the lows that were established out here in May. That number is 118.10. Right now, you're at 118.27. Earlier in the day, bottom line, the 10-year note got up to a price point of 119, tried to get back inside the range, couldn't handle it. That sets up going after the lows of the year, which is on May 17th. That would bring the 10-year yield up to 3.11. That's the high for a long period of time, not just the last year. The low for the last year has 2.2, the high is 3.11. Now, we'll go through the rest of the market, but we got to go over to Tellray, because when you take a look at this, folks, this is like over the top. This is an equity that doubled in price in one day. And then what also has happened is that they've been holding the stock, because what has happened is that they have the volatility in place, meaning that when an equity moves so fast, the circuit breakers get in place. Well, what has happened is this, and this is our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. You're going to love this, okay? Basil gets into round numbers. And in this particular case, the good old Tilray intraday hit 300 round number exact and was a leggy. So it's pretty intense. Now, what had happened right when I was getting ready for the show, it hit the 300. They put the trading pause on. And then it opened at 250, and then it went to 226. So within the matter of 3 minutes, once it opened, it went from 300 to 226, and then here they go. They just opened it back up again, and then it turned around and went to 260. So they just opened it again. Now it's up $100. It's trading 255. This is a madhouse, folks. This is an absolute madhouse. Now, do not touch this equity. I'm sure that there's a lot of money that was made in it, and there's a lot of money that was lost in it. You can, you know, that's the reality. And people are trading it. There's 26 million shares that have been traded thus far. And what we will see these circuit breakers basically get broken again. And because what you do have is this. If you're watching Tiger TV, here's the bar. It hit 300.00 right on the dot. They stopped the stock. What ended up happening? Boom. It comes all the way down to 226 on the next bar. We just opened back up. We opened back up at 265. You blink and it's a 246. This is like over the top. Yeah, in 1999, you know, in 1999, I guess, even this morning I was saying to Tommy that I almost don't even remember equities that were trading like that, but 1999 they certainly were, because JDSU, I remember we had an ABC up, it was the biggest ABC up I ever got, it was a 200 point ABC up, and it was finished in 6 days. You know, that stock went from 200 to 800, and then it went from 800, and it opened on January 3rd, I believe, or January 4th, down at 456 or something. It was an outrageous number. That's the bottom line. It's wild. So, when Tommy was doing the update, I believe, if we go stay with Telray for a second, if you want to see irrational market or irrational stock. So Telray has a market cap right now of $24 billion. And I believe that even at $24 billion, that may be a market cap larger than half of the stocks inside the S&P 500. Pretty wild. Let's go take a look at some of the other high-volume stocks out here. Telray will be right up there, there's no doubt. You get Advanced Micro down 63 cents. You have Micron Technology down 29. I think Micron's coming out with the numbers after the close here. Let me look at this. Oh, tomorrow after the close. Micron's coming out the 20th. Thanks, Dave. Apple's down 50 cents. You have Citigroup's up 267. Facebook's up 244. Let's go to Facebook for a second, because my take is that Facebook does want to go lower, but what is going on out here? This is catching a little bit out here today. Yeah, not enough, though. Not enough. It's Facebook is up 241. That wants to go to that 149 down there. But what is happening is that I think it's their Instagram deal. They own Instagram, I believe. Yeah, so in Instagram, they basically, what's going on is that Instagram, they just opened a shopping door. That's what's going on. So it's going to be interesting to see if, in fact, Instagram can get any business going. Because what Instagram does have is they have 25 million business profiles with a billion plus users. And what they're going to try to do here is that they just put a little tab on Instagram, and they're going to see if they can start moving some product out there. Now, that would make sense, because what my understanding with the Instagram is that, you know, a lot of pictures, people are doing things. Bottom line is that they know what they're doing, meaning what they like taking pictures of. So you start sending them products, guess what? Start hitting that tab. Dow Industrials up 171, Nasdaq down 15, S&P's up 1.5. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency-hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. So you got the cannabis frenzy in spades. Now, you know, you got Tilray, folks. But if you're thinking of actually trading these cannabis stocks, whether you're going to buy or sell, take a look at this ETF. So the ETF, okay, yeah, Reefer Madness, Dave, perfect, Reefer Madness. So here it comes, it's back, man. So MJ, folks, is an ETF. Inside this ETF, what I'll show you out here, is that what you're gonna see is that the largest weighting is Canopy Growth, which is 10%. You got Cronus 9.8, Tilray is 8.6. Okay, so check this out, because I was gonna take a look at this last few days. And what you have is this, is that this took out a B point, so it's an ABC structure on the way up. And when I saw Tilray up this morning, I'm saying to myself, okay, you can't short Tilray. It's not even worth trading. Bottom line, though, because what had happened is this. Tilray was the only cannabis stock that was really moving in the acceleration that you're talking about 100% in the day. That being said, MJ was an ABC structure on the way up. It was taking its B point out. Well, the thing that's pretty cool here is that the price projection was $46. Well, we hit $45.39 out here. So bottom line is that if you're itching to basically go on the other side of this, meaning that is the stock, the ETF structure, in order to basically short or go long. You know, because what you will get, if you're banking that Tilray's got to come down, bottom line, MJ will be the play. And it's not just MJ, by the way, and this is what, when I'm looking at this right now, it's really saying to me that, okay, there's going to be some kind of a, not only a blow-off the next week, but, yeah, there's going to be a blow-off, because Canopy, so check this out. So Canopy is already down. And what you have here, with Canopy Growth, so picture it, Tilray's up $100. Canopy hit a price point of 55. You're at 48 right now. But what's going on is that Canopy just turned around, and you think about getting something done quick. Well, they got this done real quick. Canopy is going to basically push out their venture capital company public, and guess when they're doing it? They're getting it out by tomorrow, folks. And what they did, so check this out. There's a lot of different things that happen. And this is where, when money is involved, folks, what ends up happening is that banks, guess what? They'll be all over in about 2 seconds. So the Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce led the deal. And this is the first time that a major bank led a deal, basically listing the company on the Canadian exchange. And on top of that, they don't not only just listed it, this is a reverse merger. That's the only way you can do this really quick. So what ended up happening is that a reverse merger is they turn around, they get another company, put the equity, in this particular case, they're putting their public arm into it. We're going to see this basically up and trading tomorrow morning. It's pretty wild. Let's go to John in Philly. Hey, John, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tommy.
How you doing, man?
Always got something to entertain us in the financial markets now, don't we?
I'm telling you, man, this is like wild. Oh, man, I'm telling you. It's something else, John. There's no doubt.
Goes around, comes around, always seems to. Tom, would you help me, please? Tom, I have been shorting, mostly scalping, the Russell 2000.
Yeah.
And I've been using the futures on that index. But of course, there's the IWM ETF.
Sure.
Tom, I have a very specific question. We see a high back on the 31st or the 4th of September.
Yeah.
And we're clearly off those highs, but it's a kind of a chop the past 10 days. My question, what do you need to see with volume and price that can give us a lead indicator that something more serious is just afoot on a, you know, decline here?
So when we take a look at it, right, yeah, in the small, what happens to the small caps, folks, is that their movement at the end of every day is pretty substantial, you know, the IWM. So as soon as we got back under this 170.20, John, which we did on Monday, we came down with 20 million. Yesterday, you go up with 13. And today, we'll probably do about 18. We get 14 now, but the IWM puts big volume in at the close also. It's like the GDX. Some of these equities, ETF equities, folks, put more volume in at the close than others, and IWM is one of them. My take right now, the IWM is going to try to make a run down to this 164 to 162 again, because you couldn't hold the number, you know, that 120. You did come down with volume, and we'll see whether it can get any lower than that. But, you know, at this particular point, this is saying to me they couldn't make the highs. You know, Monday was basically the heads up that, okay, you get a seller in it again. And, you know, for a decent market inside the Dow Industrials, you know, bottom line is that you can see that the NASDAQ doesn't have any strength, NDX doesn't have any strength, S&Ps doesn't have any strength, you know. So it looks to me like
we're going
to
go. Yeah, Tommy, thanks. Thanks very much on that. And I'm loath to pose this question, but we're looking at IWM 169.40 as we speak. And we're kind of hovering right near the lows of Monday and then a day last week. And I see what you're looking at down 164 as a prior swing low target. Just looking at the action here, is there anything that you see right here on the daily or the intraday charts that suggests to you strongly one way or another that we bounce again a little bit or immediately start moving under 169? And I know there might not be an answer, but I ask it anyway.
You know, I think we're going under. I think we're going under. And the reason I think we're going under is this. Now, I'm going to switch gears on you right now, but this is what I think it is. What's blowing my mind here, right, is that it looks to me that the dollar itself, right, the dollar is the battle is over 94. And what we haven't had yet, we haven't had big selling at the 94 level. But when you take a look at the dollar index, every time the dollar just comes down a little bit, it seems like the IWM and the NASDAQ, they just can't handle it. It's like I'm saying to myself, wow, man, is that correlation correct? And I don't know whether it is or not, but it seems that it is. You know, it's not affecting the Dow. The Dow should go higher if we're getting a weaker dollar. And I'm not quite sure, you know, why the two other indices want to go lower. But that correlation is pretty cool, you know. And it seems that the dollar can't get any traction. And this 170.20 is a big number. And it should have been able to stay over it, because when we had that volume come up, John, on the 21st, that wasn't bad. August 21st. I mean, that wasn't a bad deal. Now, it was still it was still lighter, but it wasn't a bad deal. But the way that this came down on the 12th, it came down with 21 million. It goes back up with 15, and you go back down with 20. It's like, okay, man, this thing wants lower price.
Very good. Tommy, thanks so much.
Cooking, brother. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials up 174. NASDAQ down 6.5. S&Ps are up 3.5. Coming right back.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Hi folks, this is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering 4-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at a few of the bank stocks out here. So you got Citigroup up $2.64. That baby is at the top of its range, and it has volume behind the move also. So let's see. So 73. Yeah, it's over. It's over this. I see. So we're going to 74.27. JP Morgan. Let's go to JP Morgan and take a look at JP Morgan. And what this has to do with, folks, this has to do with the bond move. Yep. There's no doubt. JP Morgan is up 363. You're going after the 118. You're trading 117.93. Bank of America, BAC. Yep, BAC caught a bid also up 90 cents, $31.13. That's going to be going after the 31.90. Yeah, so you get all, you had all these banking structures going higher. And what that also is, let's go take a look at the 30-year bond for a second. So what you're going to see is that we're going after the lows of the year, which would be the high interest rate structure of the year. In fact, oh, this is going to be interesting. So yesterday we broke down on the 30 as well as the 10. We broke the August 1st low. The low in the 30 is 140.05. And we hit 140.22. But this is interesting, man. This is rejecting this lower price right now. This would be pretty cool, actually, because this is what you have. This actually rejected lower price thus far. And as we're talking about that, we got to go back over to Tilray. You're not going to believe this, folks. Tilray just basically reopened again, and it's at 175. So since I've been on the air, Tilray has come down from $300 to $175. There is going to be some damage in this marketplace today, folks, in the broker-dealer community, which is going to be pretty intense. There's going to be blow-ups. So what is a blow-up? Okay, so a blow-up goes like this, folks, is that if you let's pitch this. It doesn't matter whether you're with TD Ameritrade, Fidelity, Intrabrokers, it doesn't matter who you're with, right? This is what happens, is that the systems that they have are dynamite. They're very vibrant. They're great systems. And what happens is this, is that you get, you're buying stock, you're selling stock, right? Bottom line, I suspect that what happened, what should have happened, is that there was no way that they'd give you a 50% margin on a stock like this. But let's say they even gave you 20%. The system itself would make sure that as it's going down, that it would sell you out of a stock because of the fact that if your account can blow up, right? Eat real easy, right? Well, what happens is that when the circuit breakers take place, a whole different dynamic takes place because everything stops. And that's the problem that broker-dealers are going to have out here today with this equity. Because what you have is that the trading stops. Like, what's going to happen, again, as if you're watching this, the trading should definitely stop again. Because we just went from 224 to 168. You know, so I suspect as you're watching the screen, you're going to see there's going to be a halt on it again. And in fact, they might have just, well, we'll find out whether they halted it for the day. But the bottom line is that there's going to be major. Oh, so that is the last haul for the day. So now what we're going to see is this. This is going to be a disaster. Oh my God, this is like sick. So they just closed the stock for the day, and the way that works is that I don't believe it might be like three halts within the day, and it has to do with what time of the day it is too. Bottom line is that this is going to be a total wipeout. You can picture, even there's plenty of people that were trading 100 shares, and guess what? If you just it's pretty intense. It's huge amounts of money. In fact, I don't think I've ever, you know, seen a, I've definitely seen a stock go down this quick, but this is going to be sad but true. Now watch this. I was talking about this MJ. This was the trade. The trade was an MJ, because there you go. So MJ just went from $45 to $38. And what will end up happening, because this is the weighting structure is so large inside of MJ. So MJ, it finished an ABC structure on the way up, as I said a little bit earlier. 46 was the number, went to 45.39. Bottom line, look at this thing. Unbelievable. Yeah, this is a straight line move too. As Tilray went down, this went from 45.39 to 38.75. Bottom line, this will go poof tomorrow morning also. And what will be intriguing, of course, is that you're going to have, if we go back to Canopy for a second, that's why they wanted to get this out tomorrow, or they wanted to get out as quick as they can. They're going to be a day late. And we're all going to have some fun with either Reef of Madness or Up in Smoke. It's all out there. And the ironic part about it is that now it's out there in the aspect that of, you know, you literally have reefer madness going on. And that reefer madness, God bless the people that were in it, because that is just amazing. You know, you talk about a round trip, oh my God. And that's going to be one of those deals that if you left your desk and came back to your desk in a second, you're in trouble. But what I would say that the bigger aspect that people are saying at their desk right now is this, is that unless you've been in the market for a bit, I suspect many of these folks don't even know what a circuit breaker is. Because we haven't had circuit break, well, we've had circuit breakers for a long period of time, but circuit breakers, they haven't seen them because of the fact that the last time that we had stocks halted go all the way back to basically 2010. You know, that's, you know, so sad but true. So this is amazing. In one day, stock doubles, and I suspect tomorrow what you'll do is the stock will open like at $97 or something. It's like, really? Or maybe just flat out and out. So these guys that started the place, they were billionaires for a day. Because I was just reading the story, the three guys that started this thing, yeah, here it is, billionaires for a day. So you get Brendan Kennedy, Michael Blue, and Christian Goth. They founded the company in 2010. Smart guys, no doubt, man. They're going to make plenty of money, so I don't think they have to worry about it. But the bottom line is that, let's see, the value topped $21 billion. They own 45% of Privateer Holdings. They're speculating that they each own basically a third of it, which would have made them each one of them worth $2.6 billion for a few minutes. And this is a trip. So the hedge fund backer in this is Peter Thiel. His fund was worth, it was worth $12 billion today because he backed. So I wonder if he owns 55% of the privateer. They're saying they own 45. Where's the other 55? Pretty wild. 877-927-6648. Dow up 174. NASDAQ down 8. S&P's up 3. Coming right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has just launched a Tiger Dollar sale for one weekend only. Through Tuesday, September 18th, you can get up to a 50% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars never expire and can be used for any TFNN newsletter or service. TFNN has a new website launching in the coming weeks, and to celebrate, we're having a Tiger Dollar sale. For all the details and to get up to a 50% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase today, visit the front page of TFNN.com before this sale ends Tuesday.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Amazon. So let's see. Amazon is considering a plan to open as many 3,000 new Amazon Go cashless stores in the next few years, according to people familiar with the matter. That's going to be interesting. So they're claiming that this is going to be like it's going to threaten chains like 7-Eleven, quick service sandwich shops, Subway, Panera Bread, mom and pop pizzerias. Oh, good luck. You're not going to get a pizzeria. Taco trucks. Well, we'll find out. Let's see what they have to say. Chief Executive Officer Bezos sees limited mealtime log jams in busy cities as a way for Amazon to reinvent brick-and-mortar shopping experience. So this is going to be wild. He is going to no doubt try to... that's cool. Let's see what happens. A convenience store that sells fresh prepared foods as well as limited grocery selection similar to 7-Eleven franchises, or a place to simply pick up a quick bite to eat for people in a rush. Amazon spokesman declined to comment. Shoppers would use smartphone apps to enter the store. Once they scan the phones at the turnstile, they grab what they want from a range of salads, drinks, snacks, then walk out without stopping at the cash register. Sensors and computer vision technology detect what shoppers take and bills them automatically, eliminating checkout. The challenge to Amazon's plan is a high cost of opening each location. The original Amazon Go in downtown Seattle required more than $1 million in hardware alone. Narrowing the focus to prepared food to go reduced the upfront cost of opening each store because it would require fewer cameras and sensors. Prepared foods also have a wider profit margin than groceries, that's for sure. Where are they going to prepare them all? Well, another warehouse, I guess. Amazon, let's see. Yes, such expansion would put Amazon back in the investment cycle. There's no doubt about it. And hey, listen, adding 3,000 stores make Amazon Go the biggest chains, among the biggest chains in the U.S. The internet giant is considering plans to have 10 locations by the end of this year, 50 locations in major metropolitan areas in 2019, and then 3,000 by 2021. Man, he doesn't fool around. It's pretty amazing. Right now in the U.S., we have 155,000 convenience stores. 122,000 of them are combined with gas stations. Amazon is targeting dense urban areas with lots of young, busy, affluent residents willing to spend little more than a typical fast food experience for better food. Amazon Go will be a threat to fast casual restaurants if it is targeting cities, said Jeff Leland, vice president of NACS. Amazon already has no lines. The key to success will be convenient locations. If it's a quarter mile where people are walking and biking, the novelty of technology won't matter. It's too far away, a quarter mile. Interesting, man. Well, here we go. The bottom line. Oh, Tilray's trading once again. Oh, let's go back to Tilray. Oh, my God. Let me see this. Here she goes. Okay, so what time is it? Okay. Yeah, so this is 15 minutes. So this is what ends up happening, these circuit breakers. We'll have to basically get the rules on the circuit breakers. So that last one then, what was going on then, it was a longer halt. That's what's happening. pretty intense. So right now we have Tilray up $34. You're trading 187. This is going to be the Wild West coming into the close. Okay, I feel like I'm at a racetrack or something. This is crazy. So really, just look if you look at this chart, we were at $300 when I started the program, and we got as low as $151.40. And right now you're at 192. Yeah, trade on 10 second bars. Here, let me see that. So I got a 10, I'll change this to a minute bar. Let me do it that way. See how bizarre this gets. No, it won't go, it won't do that for me. Yeah, well, yeah, it does do it, but I can't get enough out of it. Let me do it. I'll do it a 2 minute first. Yeah, you can't see it clean enough. That's what ends up happening. Bottom line is that, so now you're up $53. So this is what you also have happening, you know, with this equity right now. What's intriguing, it's going to be intriguing as to, you know, you have basically broker dealers in the middle of this also. And it's kind of like, what were they holding when this was happening also? You know, were they holding the bag also? Because what you do have is that there's only 9 million shares outstanding. There's 30 million shares that are traded. And so what happens is that you know that there is not 30 million shares. That's the bottom line. So when there's not 30 million shares, the market makers, you know, can basically buy and or sell without holding the stock, without even owning the stock. But guess what? They have to come up with the stock. So this is where this thing is going to be just absolutely phenomenal. So when we just opened back up, we just went from 151, we're at 217 right now. Hey, we'll check back in on it in a few minutes. Let's go back over to MJ and take a look at that, because that means look at this, you're gonna love it. See that pop too. So see the correlation you want to trade, folks, is MJ. That's what it comes down to. So that just went from a price point of $38. You're at $40.69 right now, and this is an equity that what you can do is that you can actually trade it. Because, you know, you don't have movements of $50 in like a heartbeat. You know, we went from $45 to $38 in 50 minutes. But the bottom line is that this is a tradable equity. Because of the fact that it's an ETF structure also, that you do not have to, you're not going to be paying to short the stock, to short the shares. Let's go over to the XLF, because all the banking stocks got some juice today with the bonds going south. XLF up 55 cents, trading $28.77. That's taking out the, it's right at it. But it's taking it out with volume, 28.72. You have 62 million versus 52. Put this on a weekly. Yeah, it's coming into its downdraft, though. But this is saying it can go to $29. $29.10, and right now we're $28.77. Let's go take a look at the oil market. So oil also caught a bid out here this morning. Crude oil's up 1.9%. You're up $1.33. Oh, and it got volume. This is interesting. So now we're going to really challenge these highs. Yes, no, it didn't have volume. This is interesting, man. So that's the October contract. That's the live contract, man. So this is almost like a squeeze on oil, too. This is kind of strange. 90,000 contracts. We must have just rolled. You're going into the high of 71.40. We hit 71.18, hit 71.20. Last time we were up here, we hit 71.26. That'll be strange if it gives it up at this point. Let's go to the XLE. We take a look at the XLE. XLE still can't get juice. XLE up 40 cents. You're doing 8.4 million. We did 10 yesterday, and 10's nothing. You know, you're coming into the downdraft out here that had 32 million shares as well as 26. Stay right there, folks. Coming right back. Last 10 minutes of trading. Dow Industrials right now up 172. Nasdaq down 2. S&P's up 4.5. Coming right back. We'll be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow up 173, Nasdaq is down 2, S&Ps are up 3.5. And if we go over and we take a look at the IWM inside the small caps, folks, small caps right now trading at a price point of 169.46. You're going to end up being at the low end. We're already done 15.4 million. So this will, they might put 2 or 3 million into this close. So that's saying the small caps want lower price. If you are watching Tiger TV, I got that Tilray equity up just to see whether they do get it open before the close again. Right now, that base baby had closed once again. We're going to have to get all over what the rules are inside the circuits inside the NASDAQ, okay? Because I suspect the NASDAQ, and this is what that trades on, have different rules than the NYSE when the circuits basically are broken. And, you know, we'll find out exactly what these rules are, and we'll see whether this equity opens back up. Because if you're definitely trading, well, and here's another key, folks. If you are trading Tilray, what you have to do, whether you're buying in or selling it, you never better put a market order in. But in a fast market, what you do, because this is how a broker dealer, this is how most of them work. Yeah, this is how it definitely works. You know, so let's say if you get a stock that's going down dramatically and you just want to get out, what you can do is you can put a lower price in and you'll still get the best price at that point when you get hit. versus a market price. If you're looking to get in, let's say you're selling 217 on the ticker right now. If you think that you want to get in and you know there's no way you can get it at 217, it's going topside, you could put something in and say, okay, do I want it at 222? And I don't want it over that. And that would mean that if you put it in at 222, if it's below that, you're going to get that price. And if you're day trading like that, then as soon as you put it in, I'd put an order in to sell ASAP too at the next level. Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back with numbers after the close. It looks like Tel-Ray is not going to open back up. Dow up 167, NASDAQ down 6, S&P's off 2.5, up 2.5. Coming right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
The following is a presentation of TFNN.
The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648.
Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, it's a beautiful day. Get our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take him by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
It went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. So make it a great night, folks. Create new agreements based on respect and love. Take the responsibility to make new agreements with those you love. If an agreement doesn't work, change the agreement and create a new one. Use your imagination to explore all the possibilities. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials. There we go. Had the Dow Industrials finish up 158. NASDAQ down 6. S&P's up 2.5. Gold contract up $12. Gold contract up $5.50. Trading at 1208.40. Let's start with that gold market. We take a look at it. So, gold contracts going to need more volume, folks. We have done 226,000 contracts. Not bad. Bottom line, in order to get through this 1218, though, to 1220, where these sellers are hanging out, we're going to need like 300,000 contracts. We did 273. First time we were up there, we did 304. We were up there last week. Bottom line, that's what it takes to get through that resistance line. It's quite a resistance line. They're just laying there. Each and every time it's up at that level, they basically sell those babies off. We get into the silver contract. We take a look at silver. Silver out here today was up 0.6%. You're up 8 pennies. You did 77,000 contracts. It tucked its head right at the top of the consolidation. Last time we were up here, 82,000. Today, 77. That's not bad. Okay, it's not bad. It's working its way into that level. So silver just maybe get the pop out here tomorrow. The GDX, let's go take a look at the GDX and see what kind of volume this got in at the close. Good, it got good volume. You know, you were going over a swing point of 42 million, you did 48. It's a good setup. It's a small ABC up. The A point on this was 1728. Your B was 1841. You get a buck 20, which gets you 1910 to be exact. This is a decent setup. You know, now you got an ABC structure on the way up. More than likely, we're going to see here is $19.48. Notes and bonds, bottom line is that these babies are going after the May swing low. And what we had out here is that, let me make sure you got the right one, generic one. Here we go. So if I bring up the continuous contract, you're going to see that we broke the August swing low, which was $119.02, two ticks. It's going after the May swing low, that May swing low being $118.10. And I suspect, guess what, we're going after it. The 30-year, what do we do with the 30-year bond? 30-year bond, same type of setup. In fact, the 30-year actually got into the swing point from the 18th of May. The top of that swing point is 141.12. We're at 141.02. So bottom line, we're going to the bottom of it. 140.05 is the bottom of it. The yields today, the yields did go up in the 10-year. Right now, that yield is at 3.07. For the high of the year, it's 3.11. King dollar. King dollar down 92 ticks. Not with volume, though. King dollar, bottom line, is going to need a lot more volume in order to get to lower price. King dollar is laying right at the highs of the 14th of June. That's where King Dollar had a monster day. Went from 92 all the way up to the 93.995 area. We got down to 93.910 today. Way light volume. It's going to take a lot more than that to get into it. Now, Tellray, this is the stock of the day. It's going to be the stock of the month, no doubt. This equity here, this is a cannabis stock, folks, and it basically went up in smoke today. Reefer madness, all of it. We'll be using all those connotations, there's no doubt. Pretty wild watching this whole thing shake out. Now, if you're watching Tiger TV, you're going to see that it says $214, but the reality is that this is trading at $189. This hit $300 today, and that was the first time that it got halted. It hit the circuit breaker, so check it out. It hit $300 when I started the program. Within the first 6 minutes of the program, went down to 226. So it went down $75 in a heartbeat. They held it again. Then it went down 20 minutes later into the 168 area, and 30 minutes later down to 151. 151. So it literally got cut in half again. Last night, it closed at 154. So at one point during the day, it was actually lower than the close of yesterday after being up $150. There's going to be some collateral damage, folks, inside broker-dealer accounts, bottom line, looking at this tonight. Let's go take a look at Restoration Hardware. Restoration Hardware, Red Hat. Red Hat closed at 143. That is trading out at a price point 143. Let's see what they say number-wise. That they just come out with numbers. So where are those numbers? No, those numbers aren't there yet. One second. Preview. No, I don't have those numbers yet. No numbers out there yet. Some of the high-volume equities here, they are going to be coming out with numbers. But let me take a look at some of those high-volume equities out here. So you had GE was up 20 cents. The banks were moving out here today. You had Citigroup up 236. We go take a look at JP Morgan. This was all about the bonds going lower with higher yield. JP Morgan was up $3.32. We had Bank of America, and these had wide price spread. They had volume behind the move also. Bank of America was up 79 cents, did 91 million shares. We go take a look at XLF. The XLF was up 48 cents, $28.73. And that's a monster move for the XLF. XLF is really hard to move, folks. It doesn't move with those kinds of numbers. Now, the XLF is still going into a vicious downdraft. That top of that downdraft is $29.10. Right now, you're at $28.73. So Lots of action out here inside the cannabis stocks. That's where that action was, like, in an extraordinary way. There's no two ways about that. We go take a look at the XAU, the HUI. XAU out here today goes up $1.29. You're at 66, 69. If we bring this back, it's making its way up into the larger zone, $71.63. That's what it has to get back inside. Stay right there, folks. Coming back with our man, Mr. Jim Prince. We're going to be talking markets out here. Dow Industrials finished up 158. NASDAQ down 6. S&P's up 3.5. We'll come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Jim Prince, as we do each and every Wednesday at 20 past the hour. Don't forget, folks, you can follow Jim at his website, Greatest Business on Earth, GBEmembers.com. So check it out right on the website. Jim Prince.
How are you today?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Doing really well. We got some good weather out this way now. Finally got rid of that smoke from those forest fires.
Oh, thank God. That's awesome, man. Well, you know, the smoke today was in the market, Jim, as the marijuana stocks were basically burning it up.
Oh, that's a good one. I saw that here just before we came to the segment here. Boy, that good one-liners. Always appreciate a good one-liner.
I'm telling you, man, it's hard to comprehend, folks, what these equities actually did. Just like over the top in a huge way. There's no doubt about it. Okay, so let's take a look at some of your charts here. Where would you like to start, Jim?
Yeah, let's take a look at the cocoa adjusted 10-year.
Okay, cool. Let's take a look at this baby. Okay, so talk to me. What do we have here?
Yeah, so this is a little bit different than what I've shared with you before. This is an adjusted futures contract, but it's a seasonal tendency for the last 10 years. And that blue line is the blue line is the one we want to focus on. And for cocoa, you can see it really peaked in July, and as far as this seasonal tendency goes, and then straight down into the end of the year. So with that in mind, if we take a look at the December cocoa daily chart.
Okay. Let's see. Sorry about this. Let's see. I'll get this thing up. Shame on me. December daily cocoa chart. Shame on me. Adjusted 10-year. No, I got it. I got it. Okay, cool.
Okay.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah, so here you can see how the market had actually put in a low back in August and then a bounce, and I have some support levels marked off there.
Yes.
A angled trend line, a horizontal trend line, as well as a zone there that I have in green. Well, the market bounced out of that region, went up, consolidated again, and has since moved back down. And we had a big day down today. I think it was down over 2%, now approaching that zone, but right in step with the seasonal. And I think we still have some lower price activity here down to retest the support levels that I have marked on the chart.
So when we look at these seasonal, Jim, and the cocoa, is this like, I mean, is it as cut and dried that at holidays that we like a lot of chocolate? How does this work? It just happens to be that they do have different cycles, and it not has to do with the retail eater.
Well, you know, I suppose some of it does, but I know overall it's the cycles of the market for production and crops and that sort of thing. And I'm not much of a fundamental guy. I'm just a guy off of numbers and charts myself. But I'm sure that has something to do with it. You know, much like we've looked at coffee over the last couple of weeks when we've been on. So I don't think this is a whole lot different. In this regard, I think we could easily come down and test those August lows, and we're not that far from it. And that's a big day down here today in this market.
Yeah, and when you look at this, folks, so the August lows that he's talking about is $2,100 a ton versus $2,195 right now. And the highs that he was talking about is $2,911 a ton. Pretty wild, man.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I sent over that, and I sent over another commodity. How about December cotton?
Okay, let's take a look at that. Oh my God, I'm sorry, man. I got this. Where am I? Okay, I'll find it. Go ahead. Start talking. Sorry, man.
So we've had this on a couple of different times, and I showed some projections that I had made with these blue boxes, blue rectangles, just using some market geometry.
Yeah.
And yesterday was a massive day to the downside and took up a good 50% of that projected range. And today, pretty quiet after the big day yesterday, but we're still looking for a continuation move to the downside here. As we're sitting on support right now, a horizontal support line, I'm looking for a further move down to those next levels of support and basically to fill in that projected range, because momentum, the energies that I look at based on those two indicators that I have, the middle pane and the bottom pane, clearly project price to continue to move lower.
Nice. And then the next one, I have, New Zealand dollar?
Yes. So I sent over that Forex pair.
Okay.
And one of the things with this pair here, let me grab it here, is that it is on the verge here, I think, of continuing to move higher. It's recently put in an inverted, or it's working on, I should say, putting in an inverted head and shoulder pattern. I have the left shoulder and the head mark there in the darker blue.
Yes.
And that lighter colored ellipse, that's the area I expect the market to go up and fill that in and test that 50 period moving average, which is the blue moving average line on my chart. And then after that happens, I'm anticipating that we we'll possibly see a right shoulder take place, and then maybe just a continuation move here to a little bit higher, retesting that red zone that I have marked on the chart, the lower zone there.
Nice. And then the next one would be, let's see, the euro, right?
Yes, the December euro. This is the futures contract here. And what I like about this chart is we have a kind of a large inverted head and shoulder pattern that's formed, and then the triangle pattern. But within that triangle pattern, we have price that's currently locked in, I think, the last five sessions between my 89 SMA and that 50 SMA.
Okay.
So it's really being kind of compressed, much like if you were to compress a coil. I anticipate some sort of pretty volatile move out of this range here.
Yeah. So what gets so interesting, you know, about these angles, too, is like the closer, what happens, folks, is that the closer you get to the end of the angle, many times this coil and it just keeps coiling, and that's when you really get some action. And you know what I've seen many times, Jim, is that the first move doesn't seem to be the move that happens. Like if it goes down out of it, then all of a sudden you're going to pop up, you pop up, it's all going to go down. It's kind of intriguing.
Yeah.
How these babies work, but there's no doubt that it's coiling up in a big way, isn't it?
It sure is. It sure is.
Yeah. So, there's definitely enough news over in Euroland, basically get that baby moving. Because you know, when we actually do take a look at the dollar, the euro, or the pound, they're all basically fighting it out right at. In a couple cases, it's the support, meaning the dollar, and the other ones, in those cases, it's the resistance at the highs.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely correct. Yep.
Yeah. Gotta love it. Well, listen, man, I'm glad that smoke has gone out of there. Now you get. Now, what is your weather in the winter? What kind of weather do you guys get in the winter?
Yeah, so we're in the southern portion of Oregon, so we'll get snow and ice. We get down in the 20s. Then in the summer, the peaks are, up in the 110, 112 range during August, typically. So
okay.
we get a wide range of weather here.
Pretty
cool.
We'll
have the rains coming up here, though.
Pretty cool. Now, listen, folks, you can find Jim every trading day right over his website, gbemembers.com. Check it out. He's got a lot of great learning over there. Get to understand how these futures move around. Now, in the background, is that your son?
Oh, over here?
Yeah.
Over my shoulder here? That is actually me and my wife.
Okay, no. When I always say Prince Spaghetti, then I hear someone in the background. Is that my producers?
I think that's your guy.
Oh, my God. That's so funny. Just when I'm saying that, I'm saying to myself, you know what? That's probably my producer saying Anthony. I love it.
Okay.
I love you, Al. Hey, Jim, thanks so much, man. You have a great one, a safe one.
Thanks, Tom, you too.
Thank you, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Stay right there, folks, come right back.
Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. If you'd like to be the bank and get the type of interest they receive instead of the low interest rates they give to clients, then I have an investment you may want to take a look at. I'm offering four-year secured first mortgages on buildable city lots in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment can be anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000 per buildable city lot. The interest paid is 7% per year, paid monthly. Depending on the investment, the income per month per lot ranged from $175 for a $30,000 investment to $437.50 for a $75,000 investment. If you are in the CD market, you want to look at this investment. St. Petersburg is located in Pinellas County, which is the densest county in Florida. If you're looking for an investment with your principal intact that pays a good interest rate, this may be for you. The supply is limited, so act now. For more information on these secured first mortgage opportunities, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities.
Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters. The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at Red Hat. Red Hat just came out with numbers. Red Hat closed at $143.16. The low for the year is 104. The high is 177. Right now, Red Hat is trading at 136, so you're down to $7. And let's just take a look at that. Okay, so you're going after the high volume low. Let's see what that number is down there. You're at 130. Let's pull this back a bit. Let's see what they have to say. Oh, look at this. Wow. Yeah, they, when they come out, this is off 175 going all the way back to the June. That's down a lot just in June. Okay, so let's see what numbers they have to say out here. So, okay, earnings per share, estimate 82 cents. They made 85, so no problem there. Revenue, estimate 828 million. They made 823, so a little shot on the revenue. There's got to be less than that. There's got to be more than that underneath this. So, yeah, the revenue number is 1.2% below. Bottom line is that they took the stock down 5.5% in about a heartbeat. And the way this stock is laying out right here, it looks like. So the last time they came out with numbers, you gapped from 170 down to 140, 30 bucks. This time, that's nothing, $7. But you do have this high volume low that's laying out here. And we'll see how it handles it, because what you do have is that this also, folks, has volume off the high. Volume off the high is a big problem. What happens with volume off the high? So picture this. We go back to 2016, the stock's at $66. It ran up 200% to 180 nonstop. So let me see what just a normal retracement would be. A normal retracement, when I say by a normal retracement, a 50% retracement of a move is a normal retracement. So what this did, this thus far did a 0.382 retracement, and it did that in 2 weeks. And you can see it's the extent of the move before you do a retracement as to how much damage it actually does. In this particular case, you had a stock that moved up 110 bucks from the 68 level, and that's when you get a 0.382 retracement off that higher number, which is 172, it's a problem, right? You get down to 135 in a heartbeat. You do a counter trend bounce, bottom line is that 122 is game. And 122 is a 50% retracement of the whole move that started in 2016. And the problem for Red Hat here is the aspect of how you come off the high. When you come off the high with this much volume, most times you're going to have a much larger correction than you normally do. And what that's all about, folks, that's technically, fundamentally what that's all about is that your larger funds have got out. They don't give it the support on the way down. That's how this whole thing shakes out. And that in itself is a huge problem. So we're going to go back over to Tel Ray for a bit here. So tell Ray today, this is an equity that went up 100% in one day and then crashed 45% in the matter of about 18 minutes. When all said and done, you're showing that it closed at $214, but it's really not trading at $214. It's trading at $199. It's been low as $188. Bottom line, folks, okay, this is an equity that you don't want to touch. This had a, well, even at the close today, it has a market cap of $19.9 billion. You can just imagine, this equity went public on July 18th at $17, you could buy it all day long at $20. You know, when I say all day long, it traded at $20 for about a week. It goes, and within 2 months, it went to $300 today. That being said, the equity itself still only has $9 million, $9.7 million in revenue. Never mind profit, revenue. Okay, so bottom line, don't get in the middle of this. I expect the volatility is going to continue. It'll sort itself out. I'm sure it's going to be a great equity. Get some smart people behind it. But guess what? If you want to see something that's really bizarre, we did this yesterday, but I have to do it again today because it's so outlandish now. So picture this. The largest gold company in the world is Barrick Gold. Barrick Gold has a market cap of $12.3 billion. Now, this gets better. Barrick Gold takes in $7.6 billion a year. Now, to the bottom line, they bring $500 million, okay? You know, it's $550 million they bring to their bottom line. That's what they're going to bring this year. Last year, they brought $750 million, okay? Bottom line, Tilray, just gross, they plan on doing $41 million this year. That's gross. They plan on losing 40 cents a share. So bottom line is that they plan on losing about $40 million. You can see the differential here. The differential intraday today, and this is where markets are absolutely irrational. Intraday today, Tilray was more valuable on a market cap than 50% of the stocks inside the S&P 500. That's how bizarre this whole deal was. Pretty intense. And, you know, the other, now let's go over the Canopy, because what you have with Canopy, so Canopy Growth, which was by market cap as well as revenue, that has a $10.9 million market cap. And the differential there is that they are projected, they're projected to do $371 million this year. They still only did $25 million last quarter. And you see the differential is pretty intense, because you have Tilray still saying it's worth almost double the amount of Canopy. Now, what Canopy is doing, now this is where this is going to get wild, and they're smart doing it, but they may be a day late. What Canopy did intraday today is that, because it's such a frenzy, when there's a frenzy, folks, going on in any market, and particularly in a public market, the people that are raising money, that's when you have to get the stock out there, because that's when people will buy the stock. And that's what actually funds the next acceleration in companies. So what Canopy did out to here today, they have a venture arm. And so what they did is they did a reverse stock merger today. Canadian National Imperial Bank, who hasn't dealt with any pot companies whatsoever. In fact, the large banks have been staying away from them. Bottom line, they led the deal. That's how quick the cannabis business has turned on now. So you had, that's a major, major Canadian bank. They led the deal. They got the deal done. And guess what? It's coming out tomorrow. And it's coming out tomorrow, folks, because people are going to be paying up for the deal. Now, I wouldn't be paying up for the deal. That's the bottom line. These things are going to come back to earth. When they come back to earth, then they're going to be sweet little buys. That's what it comes down to. Well, I don't know if they're going to be sweet little buys, meaning you're going to be paying for their growth, because they're going to be there. The boardrooms of the large beverage companies, the boardrooms of the large food companies. They're past scratching their head. They need a piece of this, because the bottom line is that the beverage companies are going to have infused THC, infused CBDs. The food companies are going to have edibles. And if they want a piece of it, they got to get a piece of it right now.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has just launched a Tiger Dollar sale for 1 weekend only. Through Tuesday, September 18th, you can get up to a 50% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars never expire and can be used for any TFNN newsletter or service. TFNN has a new website launching in the coming weeks, and to celebrate, we're having a Tiger Dollar sale. For all the details and to get up to a 50% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase today, visit the front page of TFNN.com before this sale ends Tuesday.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished up 158, NASDAQ down 6, S&P's up 2.5. Volume-wise out here, folks, what we did is this. We did 846 million. Oh, that's a big one inside the NYSE. That's saying the NYSE is going after its highs. Inside the composite, we did 2.1 billion. NYSE. Let's go over to the NYSE and look at it first then. Because we're not that, we're really close to the January highs. Right now, you're 26,405, and January 26th, we were at 26,616. Yeah, that's not going to be hard. That's going to be easy to take out. This will go after it this week. That's the way that seems to be shaken out. Now, if we stay with these cannabis stocks for a second, folks. Now, if you're going to trade, bottom line is you're getting all excited about how these trade. The equity that you want to be trading is MJ, if you don't want to get your head handed to you on a platter, folks. And this is why. So MJ, meaning that I know that we have a lot of people that like to trade out there, but I would suggest you do not touch Tilray, not even close, okay? this equity here is an ETF, and the inside the ETF, Tilray has a very large weighting. You know, it's Tilray, it is Canopy Growth, and it's Cronus. I'll go through them for you. So Canopy is the number one weighting structure, 10%, 10.1. Cronus is 9.8, Tilray's 8.6, Aurora is 7.3, GW Pharmaceuticals is 6, CanTrust is 4. Bottom line, those are some of the biggest ones out there. So what you also have is that you have an ETF, and on an ETF structure, you can buy and sell those in a heartbeat without even, you know, when, depending on how long you've been in the marketplace. What used to happen years ago, folks, is that you could only sell short on a downtick, on an uptick rather, not on a downtick. Now you can sell short anytime you want. Well, the ETFs are basically even easier, because what ends up happening is that you're not really borrowing. They just make and destroy ETFs by 50,000 at a pop. That's how the ETFs are made and destroyed. So what ends up happening is that where Tilray goes, okay, this is going to be pushing around MJ. And I'll show you intraday today if you want to see how intense it is. And what happened is that when Tilray had hit, well, first off, let me do this at the beginning, because I was going to trade this and put this in the newsletter this morning, but what had happened is that it had not done the full price projection of an ABC structure on the way up. And that's what it was doing. You know, yesterday it had taken the B point out of an ABC structure on the way up. Well, it was a very large ABC. Your A point on this is $25.10. That was the low of August 14th. Your B point, $38.50. You get $13. Your C point is $33.50. So you're talking about a $46.50 A to B. We hit $45.39 today. So you can see, if you want to trade this, this is the tradable vehicle, so you don't get caught in a major whiplash. Now, that being said, you know, when Tilray was at $300, I was talking about this then too. If you thought that was too high and it would come back to earth, well, bottom line is that, you know, none of us knew that it was going to come back to earth $75 in like 10 minutes, but that's what it did. And you can see what ended up happening with MJ. MJ went from $45 at right when I was getting on, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, bang, right down to 38. It was a nonstop on the way down because of what Tilray was doing. I can go like this. I can compare them. This is pretty cool. So I'll put TLRY. So you can see the exact. Okay, so update that. And there you go. What you're looking at there is this. You're looking, the green line, as you're looking at how Tilray was moving lower. The white line is how you're looking at the ETF was moving lower. You can see there's a direct correlation. I want to put up, let's compare this to, I can only do one at a time. Okay, so now I got to do, I'll put this up just so you can see what the difference is. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to put up Canopy Growth. And the reason I'm going to put up Canopy is that you can see Canopy hadn't been up 100%. So like when you're dealing with an ETF, number one, you want to know what the weighting structures are inside it. And then when you see something that's so skewed as we just did inside the cannabis market, meaning that you had one stock that was up 100%, the others were trading normally. As I update this, what you're going to see is, oh, this is cool. It kept that in there, too. It actually kept the Tilray in there. I can do this two or three times. Okay, so now the little pink line, okay, ends up being Canopy Growth. And you can see Canopy Growth was minimal. You know, it was trading normal compared to Tilray. So instead of getting involved in an equity that has that much much volatility, this is going to be a good vehicle to take a look at whether you're buying in or selling. You know, today was a great vehicle to sell. You know, what will end up happening in the future, and if I pull this back a bit, you know, you can sit there and you wait for a nice pullback. Bottom line is that, you know, there's no reason that these cannabis stocks, they end up pulling back. They're going to be down, you know, this could be at like $32, and you're looking for a different play across, spread across a lot of different companies. That might be the play. If we go over and we just take a look at Canopy again. So what you have here is this. See, this also finished an ABC up when it hit the 56. Now the real question is going to be, is this going to be a high-end consolidation, or does it get back into where it started from, which is 34? So we went from 5. So it's the $30 A to B, which gets at 46, but yet we hit 56. Yeah, this will pull back. It finished its ABC structure on the way up. You're going to get big volatility, but this will also get pulled back. You know, what we definitely do have, as I said right before the last break, is that you have a very large cut. Well, it said it all, actually, with the Canadian Bank, Imperial Bank of Canada today, being the lead underwriter for the Tilray Venture Capital. I mean, for the Canopy Venture Capital arm. That says it all. And it would make sense because you get where the 9th, where it's the 19th of September, the 27th of October, pot's legal, recreational in Canada. We'll see what kind of flack the other G7 countries are going to give Canada, particularly us. You know, we'll see that whole shakes out. Because if you don't know this yet, what did happen is that one of our administrators from, which has been charged with the borders, are saying that flat out, if he got interviewed, and that if in fact Canadians that are either in the business, working for the business, are actually owning the companies, they'd have a problem coming into the U.S. I understand that is the law. We'll see whether that's going to fly or the money from the banks are going to fly. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Dates newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With over $56 million in cash and over $66 million in working capital, Great Panther Silver is positioned as a company with a solid foundation and poised for growth. While completely unhedged to the price of silver, Great Panther retains 100% ownership in 2 producing mines in Mexico, which is the top silver producing country in the world, along with future potential production in Peru. Great Panther is highly leveraged to the price of silver, and after a great year of performance in 2019,
2016, Great Panther Silver has a strong outlook for 2017 as well. With good liquidity in trading and strong fundamentals on the balance sheet, while remaining completely unhedged to the price of gold and silver, now is a perfect time to take a closer look at this equity. If you'd like to find out more about Great Panther Silver, then go to greatpanther.com or check them out on the NYSE Market, symbol GPL, or the TSX, symbol GPR.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow finish up 158. NASDAQ down 6, S&P's up 4.5. Now, you get some divergence out here, folks. You did have volume come in the Dow Industrials out here today. We did 8 billion shares. You are right next to the high. So this January 26th high, it's taken a long time for it to hit it, but more than likely we're going to get up into that high of 26.16. Right now, it closed at 26.404. That being said, NASDAQ, NDX 100, the different ballgame. The Qs right now are at 182. They basically are getting more pressure on the lower side than the upper side. We are right next to the high. The high is 187. But bottom line, the longer that you stay inside 182.99, the higher the probability is it wants to go to lower price. Small caps do want lower price. The small caps out here today, we did 100. We're at $169.65. We did volume out here of 17.5 million. You closed at the lows of the day, 169.65. Anything under the 170.20 area is saying it wants to go to the lower end of this consolidation, which is the 162 area. The king dollar is fighting like crazy over this 94 area. We've been down there, hasn't been able to catch a bid, but you don't have any sellers at that area also. What I do expect we're going to see is that the gold contract as well as silver, well, gold's at 1208, 1218 to 1220, that's where the sellers are lying in a big way. We did some decent volume out here today. You got Wednesday in the marketplace, Thursday, Friday, I expect what you're gonna see is that gold's gonna try to get into that number once again. It's failed the last two times up there. Dollar, that would be saying that also the dollar is gonna try to get into the June 14th level, and the June 14th levels of the dollar had big action on the way up. That's where the dollar went up 2 pennies, okay? Because, you know, when I'm talking about 101 ticks, when I'm talking 500 ticks in the dollar is a penny, a half a penny, folks. That's how that works. Always remember, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Come join us tomorrow morning. Jason Path, great show. Morning market kickoff, 8:30. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're gonna love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.